undercard, I'm in charge of the starship. An artist in the jargon of Martians, charging off in the darkness where no man's come before.
It started from an innocent project and ended with Woman Hell. Woman Hell Law Firm is the word firm that got me out. Woman Hell Law Firm, New York City. And, Woman Cutler Hell is the law firm that got me out. Really? Excuse me for my voice. Really? I believe I'm going to talk about the case. I'm going to talk about it. Right. I think that the case is done, is over with. You know, I've been through the stages of where, you know, my case is, still ongoing. That's the best way I can put it, in terms of the lawsuit. That's it, you know. So that's the reason why I didn't want to.
That's still one of the getting you now.
Yeah, Woman Law Hell Law Firm got the case.
And so take me a little bit through how you got in touch with you and how this law happened.
Well, it started from ESPN. They heard about my story. And when ESPN heard about my story, I got nominated for the Arthur Ashe Courage Award. Next thing I know, I got the Arthur Ashe Courage Award. While I was up on the stage, I made a statement that I would like to have one pro fight. So Bernie heard about it. They seen it on ESPN. They invited me to the camp after they found out that I failed the first test. Being with taking a test by myself, I had nobody. You know, and so I went out there, you know, I did the best I could do for what I had. And now, when I came over to the Bernard Hopkins camp, I passed. You know, thank God for that, you know. Even Oscar De La Hoya was cheering me on in the corner, so that made it even a lot more, you know, that was cool. I felt that, you know, I said, thank you, man. You know, and then when the commissioner passed me, it was like a relief. It was a relief, you know. Okay, you know, I didn't give up, it paid off. Now here it is, I'm about to fight on the Bernard Hopkins undercard with Chad Dawson. You know, what more can I ask for? And don't get me wrong, I'm not going to go out here to lay down. I'm going out here to fight. I'm not going out here to let the guy just whip my butt. It's not going down like that. I'm going to let the world know, yo, even at my age, hey, don't tell me what you can't do. You know?
And what's kind of advice to Bernard give you?
Bernard gave me a whole lot of advice. Bernie has given me pointers. He has given me, we ran together. You know, so he's giving me other things, you know, to help me, you know, with punches, you know, but he still had to deal with his training as well. So whatever he gave me, I ran with it, and I'm still running with it, and I watch him sparring. The guy is a beast in the sparring. So I learned a lot just by watching him.
What's it like that your first pro fight's on a major undercard?
Just like getting out of prison. Brand new experience, man.
Did you ever imagine something like this could happen?
Huh?
Did you ever imagine when you're in prison that something like this could happen?
Yeah. I thought that I had a chance. I never, you know, I said I would love to turn pro when I get out. You know, and a lot of people said, that's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. And here it is. It did happen. You know. Blessings of God. You know, it was a gift. And I'm going to do the best I can with it.
And before you went to jail, were you an amateur boxer?
Yeah, I was employed passing boxing camp up in New Paltz, New York for a little while before this happened to me. Then I got arrested, and then I was in Sing Sing, and then that's when I boxed even more while I was in Sing Sing prison. And so, you know, I did the best I could do in there, and now I'm out here, and I just want to know what it's like to feel to be as a pro. You know, because I consider myself an athlete, and, you know, now I'm getting that chance.
You were the champ at Sing Sing.
Yeah.
But they closed down that program.
They closed it down in 1990. Last time I had a fight was over 20 years ago, 1990. Yeah. Last time I had a fight.
What were the fights like in prison? Let me rephrase that. What were the boxing fights like?
It's like any other fight. You know, the only difference is you don't want to lose in front of population. Population say, oh, you better not lose. You better not lose. So, you know, I think that was more encouraging, you know, because this is my house. This is where I live. And this is where I got to be, you know. So I fought not defending my territory to the best of my ability. You know, that was a good part.
You've been getting a lot of feedback from the guys you were in with, like getting a lot of emails or notes or whatever.
Well, I still socialize with people from the inside. Of course, they're going to be happy that they found out that this is happening to me, you know. And the word is going to spread, you know, and that's going to make people on the inside, I believe, feel that, yo, if he can do it, I can do it. You know what I mean? That's the encouragement that I want to give back. Not only for the inmates, but also people of the population and society all throughout the world, if possible.
What about when you won that award? How much did that mean to you when you won the Arthur Ashe Award?
It meant a lot. First of all, to be compared with a lot of athletes is one thing. But to be compared to Muhammad Ali, Nelson Mandela, Billie Jean King, Howard Cosell, come on, man. I'm number 19 on the list. That was the last thing in the world I suspected. You know, and now to be under the Bernard Hopkins undercard, that's even something more I least suspected. And so now these are the things that, you know, I got to take heed to. And now I'm no longer just, you know, what Charles Barkley was saying, not a role model. I am a role model. Because if I make one bad mistake, whether I like it or not, it's going to fall back on everybody. And I can't allow that to happen.
Have you and Bernard talked a lot? Because obviously he had somewhat similar experience about being in. I mean, you guys share some similar stories, I would imagine.
Sure, yeah. When we ran together, Bernie, me and Bernie were talking about certain things, you know. And Bernie's a real cool guy. A lot of people may underestimate him the way that he think. I think he is a very analytical thinker. He has his ways of dealing with things, and people may misconstrue him for it, but Bernie is Bernie. And that's a walking living legend. You know, everybody, you can't understand a lot of walking living legends. You know what I mean? Because they all have their own world they live in.
What kind of advice is he, maybe one piece of advice maybe he's given you?
You know, to watch out for the young guys when they attack you, how to slip the punches and, you know, counter up often and stuff like that. You know, advice like that again.
What about, like, life advice? Is he giving you a piece of that?
He knows I'm not going to. That's the end of that. I'm not even thinking. He can look at me and see that, you know. Nah, we ain't even discussing that part. I'm not even thinking about going back in there. You know, maybe to do some public speaking, I'll do something like that. But go back and live never again.
What's your long-term boxing goal? Is this a one-shot deal? Or?
Yes. You know, I want to get this over with, you know, and then I want to get my own gym. You know, in fact, I got a Dewey Bozella Foundation that just got started. My lawyers just got started. So if people want to get in contact with my lawyers, Wim Hell Law Firm, Ross Brissenbaum, and they can get in contact with him. And they can tell him, you know, he'll tell them about the Dewey Bozella Foundation.
Where would that be, the gym?
It's going to be in Newburgh, New York. I would like to be in Newburgh, yes.
Is that where you live now?
I'm in the Beacon area. I'm 10 minutes away from where I want the gym to be at.
So suppose this goes well, maybe you knock the guy out quick, you know what, maybe another one,
My wife will kill me, man.
Anyway, this is a light, a funny question, so don't take this seriously. If you're just going to do one fight, did you have any kind of grudge with anybody in the joint? Maybe you say, hey, come on, turn pro, well, let's get it on in the ring.
There's quite a few. There's quite a few. But I let it's gone, it's done, it's over with, you know, move on. You know, I've seen a lot of correctional officers since I've been out, and we said hello. No bad feelings.
Well, about a fellow yeah. Person.
No bad feelings.
Might be out on the street. You stole my mashed potatoes.
No. That's gone. That's over with. You know, them days over with. You know, I would hope that if I did run into a guy who didn't like me, he would just keep, right, you know, hi and goodbye and keep it moving. I hope there would be no hard feelings.
Well, I'm sure you're better off than 99% of them now anyway.
Yeah, there's a lot of people that came out that are doing good.
Yeah, but as good or better than you. Say two years from now.
I would hope so.
Right?
I would hope so.
You're one of the 1%ers, not one of the 99%ers.
Okay. That's good.
You say you're open at the gym. You plan on training young men?
Sure. My thing is to help the young kids as well as young adults to, you know, turn their lives around and not make the same thing, make a bad choice that can cause them a lifetime of misery. That's the main thing.
What's like this last 6 months with the awards and now situations like this with all the cameras? When you get to LA next week, it's probably tenfold of what this is. And, you know, has it been a whirlwind for you?
It's like everything else, you know. I've been involved with what we call, I help start one of the foundations in Sing Sing, which was a really big attention to the arts. I've been involved in numerous plays. I acted in numerous plays. You know, and I think that, you know, it's something I would also like to get involved in one day, you know, because I've been involved in it with Catherine Vikings. And so these are the things that, you know, help me to prepare myself to be able to talk to people like you. And being up on the stage and doing presentations and stuff like that. Also getting my master's degree. So that helped me. You know, to be able to be in this position.
What's the weight for this fight? Is there a contract or what are you planning on weight?
What do you mean?
What's the weight?
190 pounds, 200
pounds? Oh, I'm going to fight a cruiserweight. I'm going to fight a cruiserweight.
It's 200.
Yeah, it's between 190 and 200.
You'll probably be weighing about 198?
195. You're a meat.
said you were married. Were you married when you were in jail, too?
I got married to a woman by the name of Trina Bozella.
After you got out?
No, while I was in the inside.
Okay.
Yeah.
How was that, getting married in jail?
It's better than being married to someone else. Come on, man. What do you think?
Conjugal visits?
Yes, sir. Come on, man. Yeah, we got, no, what happened was we were allowed to have, at one time we were considered civilly dead. Lifers were considered civilly dead. They passed the law that lifers were allowed to get married in 1990, and I got married in 1995 to my wife, and I've been married to her since, all the way to today. You know, so, you know, it was a gift. We call that one time being considered civilly dead, meaning that I was 84A0172, and that's it. I was just a walking number.
Is she still in, or is she out as well?
What do you mean?
In prison.
My wife was never in prison.
I thought you both were in. Okay.
You can't do that.
Dewey, they say you're officially a pro when you step through the ropes for the first time. You know, with someone, everything you've been through, what do you think it's going to feel like, that moment when you first step through the ropes and through everything? You're now a professional fighter.
I am a professional fighter right now. That's all. It's
got
a
his
rap.
License.
It's a wrap. You know what I mean? I already stepped on my first rope, and I entered inside this camp right here. I entered inside this camp. You know, that was that. They didn't want to help me to get it, and now I'm a run.
Is Jimmy going to plan to open? Amateur, pro, both?
What do you mean?
Amateur boxers and pro boxers. Have this Jimmy plan to open a new brand?
Absolutely. If, you know, whoever comes in, but it's going to be for the kids.
And anybody you have, do you want to be on your staff with you? Any names you were thinking of asking to come on board?
I'll worry about that when it happens. There's a few people, but I'm not going to mention their names right now.
You've asked them already? Or?
No, when it gets up off the ground and I got it, that's when I live it. You know what I mean?
Thank you.